Dublin's fund managers and universities are building up a reputation for expertise in high-quality environmental, social and governance-linked investments. I'm going to be talking to Sean Hawkshaw, CEO of KBI Global Investors, about how the city is becoming a centre of excellence for this much-in-demand style of responsible investing. Sean, many in the investment industry see 2020 as the year in which environmental, social and governance investing finally became mainstream. Did it really take the COVID crisis to make this happen?
We had strong momentum coming into COVID. I think at the end of 2019, the various surveys showed that about something between 25 and 30% of professionally managed assets had some form of ESG overlay. But there's definitely no doubt that the COVID really was a very strong impetus. And it's hard to really get our heads around why that is. I think it created all of us reevaluated a lot of things that we were doing, aspects of our lives. I think from an investment point of view, there was a lot more focus on resilience and sustainability, and a feeling that there was a huge interconnectedness between various economies and various types of industries. I think people felt vulnerable and, you know, started taking global threats much more seriously within their investment strategies. So from that point of view, I think COVID has actually, well, it has moved the dial, there's no doubt about it. I mean, we've seen a huge surge in flows into ESG, responsible investing strategies and impact strategies over the last few years. And we've also seen a change in behavior from the corporates starting to come through. I think part of that is a recognition that, you know, if they don't move their business models to a certain extent, that they're going to have to pay a price, and that price could be in terms of a higher cost of capital for their funding going forward, you know, if they continue to embrace more redundant business models. You know, there's top-down and bottom-up influences. There's no doubt in my mind that it is mainly driven by asset owners and investors.
I know that every decade has its bright young things coming through. We remember the angry young men of the 50s and 60s, the Woodstock generation of the 70s, the yuppies of the Thatcherite 80s, the cool Britannia of the 90s. These millennials coming through in the 2000s, are they different? Do they have a stronger interest in ethical investing than their parents? And will the demographics work in favour of your industry?
I think so. Well, I mean, to follow your music analogy, was it Bob Dylan's song, "You Don't Need the Weatherman to Know Which Way the Wind Blows"? I think the younger generations are not just looking at making the fast buck. They're looking for sustained prosperity into the future. And they're very focused on the type of world that they're going to be spending that wealth in, you know, in 10, 15, 20 years down the line, and recognize the threats if they don't take action now to do that. Surveys have been done. I've seen FT surveys on female decision-making in relation to responsible investing, that they're more likely to select responsible investment choices. So diversity is an issue. Millennial and age profile, absolutely yes. We see it in the decision makers in both, I think initially probably in family offices where you had second and third generations of the families coming in and making decisions. So we probably saw that coming 3 or 4 years ago. But now within consultants, you've got more younger decision makers and advisors there. Within the wealth management industry, obviously the age profile is beginning to become very apparent to where the decisions have been made. But, you know, just to give one example of the momentum we've seen over the last while, in December 2020, the Net Zero Asset Management Initiative was kicked off, which was to sign up investment managers who would have an objective of net zero emissions from the portfolio by 2030, with some interim targets along the way. But over the last 6 months, I think it's 128 fund managers have signed up to that. And that represents something like $45 trillion in assets under management, which is a huge proportion, a huge momentum in a very, very short time. So it just gives you a sense as to how the decision-making is beginning to change.
And this younger cohort of investors you've been talking about, Sean, you know, many of them are fairly recent graduates of the universities. I mean, what sort of role are the universities playing in developing expertise in ESG disciplines? And how closely are you working as a fund management group with the universities in Ireland?
The educational situation, particularly in financial degrees, postgrad and graduate degrees, has started to move over the last 2 or 3 years, and we've seen some very interesting and innovative programs coming through. From an industry perspective, I know the various industry bodies in Ireland are starting to engage with universities. For example, I'm involved with the Irish Association of Investment Managers. We've recently just set up one of our working groups with which we'll have a focus on education, working with the universities. I think it's not just about universities, it's also about schools. And you know, for better or for worse, I think we all have to improve the profile and perception of the financial services industries in schools before people even get to universities. I think there's work to be done there, which is underway. But then if you take the education agenda further and look at the people who are working in the industry, there are some very, very good initiatives going on in Ireland. Focused at educating people, you know, like myself and others who've been in the industry for quite some time, and also people working on the regulatory side on ESG and responsible investing initiatives. The UNPRI Academy is available to people in the industry on a subsidised basis through a SkillsNet programme. We've got a CFA ESG programme, and there are many others out there, and all of which are doing what is most important. I mean, if we're to sort of grasp this change and this opportunity, it's about upskilling and innovation, and education is absolutely key to that. What I'm excited about is we've seen some really, really good graduates coming out of the Irish universities who are coming to firms like KBI and others in town who absolutely want to have a career in responsible investing. And we didn't have that 3 years ago or 5 years ago. So that really gives me a lot of optimism for Dublin as a centre.
And is the pace of development and innovation fast enough, Sean? You mentioned Bob Dylan earlier on. I hate to echo the song Knocking on Heaven's Door, but will you and I still be around for these dreams to be realised?
I believe we will. But I would still say, you know, if you look at the whole area, the whole carbon emissions and managing carbon emissions within portfolios, I mean, we're probably 3 or 4 years into a 25 or 30 year program in terms of getting to where we need to be on that. So, you know, there's a long, long way to go on it. And I think what's really encouraging is the fact that people are investing in these sustainable investment strategies now for the right reasons. And it's not based on philosophy, it's based on where they see the alpha opportunity going forward in terms of some of the solutions providers around global resource shortage, around circular economy, water use, sustainable infrastructure. All of these things are really, really exciting investment opportunities. So for that reason, I think we're very early stages. But, you know, I think you and I are going to see a lot of it in our lifetime.
Well, I'm glad there's still opportunities for us ahead. Sean Hawkshaw, thank you very much.
Thank you.